Hi, so in this video, I will talk to you about how I went from starting a career in IT as a help desk person to becoming a cloud engineer without taking any certification whatsoever. So let's get started. Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Carolyn. I am a cloud engineer slash software developer slash entrepreneur. I make videos about those three topics. So if you like this video and you want to see more like this, make sure to like and subscribe. And also, I have bloopers at the end of my videos usually, so make sure you watch until the end to see the funny things that happened when I was recording the video. So let's get started with the beginning. So I started a career in IT as a manager of a computer lab. So I was in charge of making sure that computers were ready for our summer camps. I was in charge of making sure the software was installed. I was in charge also of teaching and creating curriculum at the university I was studying. So at that time, I was studying for a bachelor's in physics. So physics is an awesome topic, but there's no job in real life in physics. So after college, when I was done, I got into grad school for a master's in computer science, but then I ended up not going because they were like, oh, you have to take the entry-level classes, blah, blah, blah. A lot of things that I won't get into, at least not in this video. And I got a job in IT. So I started my official career, not like my career during college, but my official legal career as an IT technician, as what my title was, a client support specialist. So that means I went around the building fixing computers, setting up computers, deploying computers, helping people with changing computers, helping fix broken software, reinstalling software, and all that stuff. So very entry-level stuff, very hands-on, very working with the customer, working with somebody. So how did I get from starting as a desktop support specialist slash client support specialist slash entry-level IT technician to becoming now a cloud engineer? Well, it took me 8 years, but I want to say that the cloud wasn't very popular back then. It was not really something that companies were looking to move into very aggressively. So that's why it took a while to get from there to cloud engineer. Furthermore, I was actually not planning on staying as a career in IT. I just wanted to do IT to pay the bills, and I just ended up staying for a very long time. So how did I get there? So it's important to cover a little bit about me. So I am, like I said in my introduction, I am a software developer. I do software development. I'm good at programming. I like programming. I learn a lot of programming languages. So how did the entry-level technician role connect to cloud engineer through programming? Well, I like programming, like I said, and that led me to doing a lot of automation work. So one of my rules is that if I have to do something on a computer three times or more, I write a script to do it. I find a way to automate that process. So that's how I lived my career as an in IT, is by trying to find ways to automate things that I have to do so that I don't have to do them over and over again. Furthermore, that's something that actually helps other people in your company, in your role. If you work on automating things, they will really appreciate it because that's one less thing they have to do. So I went from entry-level technician to senior-level entry-level technician. So, and the change for that is, again, my programming experience. I did some automation, a lot of PowerShell stuff and software packaging and things like that. So that's how I went from one to the other. Then I went to senior technical analyst in a different group. And again, automation. That was my thing. I am very good at taking little tasks and making them into an automated way. So this way it saves a lot of time. I created a lot of software and scripts that created a lot of automation and reduced the workload of a lot of people. Then when I went to desktop engineer and then eventually to cloud engineer, that was the whole theme. The whole reason I got this job was because I automate things. The cloud is very much an automation and optimization game. If you want to do cloud, you have to find ways to automate things. You have to find ways to optimize things. And that's really the big game, and that's really the big theme of cloud is automation and optimization. You don't want to pay too much for things, and you don't want to buy things that are overpowered or underpowered. You want to be able to be always just right with your resources, so you pay only for what you need. And that's where I managed to get my job as a cloud engineer, is I started playing around in Azure a little bit, and I did things in there to automate. So I played with Azure Functions. I played with a few other things that really led to nice automation work that really made the cloud like a perfect environment for my skills. So now how can you, on the other end of the camera, become a cloud engineer today? Well, there's a few things you can do without having any certifications or spending any or not a lot of money. So the first thing you can do is set up an Azure account or set up an AWS or GCP, Google Cloud Platform account, and start playing with the cloud. It's very easy. It's very cheap. I know at least Azure gives you $200 worth of credit for your first month. And they have a lot of services that are free for the first 12 months. And they also have a lot of services that are free forever. So you can get started on your own without any certification, without anything, and learn the cloud on your own. Another thing is all these companies really want you to use the cloud. So they have training resources that I will put down in the description of this video that will help you go through what you need to know for the certification. You may not need to get the certification, especially if you're moving in an internal role. I think it's more important to have certification when you're moving outside of your company and trying to find a job into a different company as a cloud engineer. But for an internal role, you can show your knowledge, you can play around with things and just with those courses. So I highly encourage you to take those courses. They're very quick modules that you can play around with. I think they discontinued the lab environment where you could have a little sandbox and do the exercises, but you can probably do that on your own with your free or your basic subscription at very little cost. So that's what I encourage you to do to become a cloud engineer. Of course, also try to play in the cloud and at your company. Try to show interest at your company to do some cloud work. If you have a little project that you have an idea what to do that could be good, a good use case for the cloud, and you can show that you can implement it maybe in your account and then transfer it to your work, that could be also a solution to become a cloud engineer at little to no cost to you. All right, so that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching until the end. Make sure to like this video if you liked it. Obviously, if you came all the way here to the end, you probably liked it. And don't forget to subscribe if you are not a subscriber, so you can see more content like this. And if you click the notification bell, you can be notified next time I post a video. Now, on to the bloopers. Oh, cloudy sky, your battery is dead. Hello.
I just got cloudy sky.
Your battery is dead. How did that happen? It's okay.
Did you leave it on?
I did leave it on.
Well,
but not now. It's just. Hello?
Move Cloudy Sky over a little bit. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Well, too bad, so sad.
All right.
Whenever you're ready.
Are we recording?
Yeah.
Oh, so I'm being recorded doing this?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Weird. Okay. Hi. Hi. Hi.
Do you want me to stop?
No. Wait, where was I?
I don't know.
Oh, where was I? Blah, 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 blah. So, all these companies really want you to use the cloud. So they have training resources that I will put down in the comment down in the... So they have training resources that I will put down in the description of this video that will help you go through what you need to know for the certification.